Hey, it's Macha again, your food historian, and today's episode is about turmeric. Turmeric, last year's hot new superfood, seems to have graduated to Food of the Year for 2017. It's been touted as one of the world's greatest anti-inflammatories. But what is it? Where does it come from? And does it even work? If you live in the US, Britain, or Canada, you probably know turmeric as the thing that makes curry yellow. It is the primary ingredient. On the other hand, turmeric is not required to make it a curry, but that's a whole nother episode. Turmeric has been a staple ingredient for the last 4,000 years introduced by the Vedics of India. Its species name is Curcuma longa, and it's a tuberous herbaceous plant much like ginger and galangal. These are all known as rhizomes, little bulbous things that grow underground, which, cool fact, they're underground stems, they're not roots. Didn't know that before I was doing research on this. Turmeric has always been used as a medicinal plant, and what makes it special is it contains something called curcumin. Curcumin, which is confusing because I always think about cumin, and it's not, has been touted as a powerful antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, antiviral, antibacterial, antifungal, and anti-cancer. That seems so impressive, but is it true? Basically, the answer is no, but I'm going to give you a kind of maybe, yeah, it is true. According to the Journal of Medicinal Chemistry, curcumin is not easily absorbed into the body, and they did not observe significant changes in cellular properties. Associate Professor Michael Walters from University of Minnesota's Institute for Therapeutics Discovery and Development told Time magazine that turmeric falls into the realm of folklore. Guido Paoli, a pharmacist and professor of medicinal chemistry and pharmacology at UIC College of Pharmacy in Chicago, told the Global News, "Our study looked at the effects of curcumin, which is just one compound in the spice. But on the other side of the coin is curcuma, the actual plant, and it produces tens of thousands of different compounds. It's very improbable that curcumin will make it into a drug, but we want to encourage more research on curcuma. From an ethnobotanical perspective, we can't say that the way in which people in Asia have been using turmeric for centuries to cure ills is invalid. There is clinical significance. And, like so many other medicinal plants, sometimes they require other plants or other properties like proteins to increase their absorption. So it's totally possible that curries are the magical mix that help us gain all the benefits." So while turmeric is not a wonder drug, it is kind of beneficial. In a totally unscientific study, I found that every time I have a headache or even an upper backache, if I put about a spoonful of turmeric into 8 ounces of almond milk and just put a little bit of honey in there, I drink it cold, you can heat it up, it tends to get rid of my headache. Maybe that's like, I don't know, I might be imagining it, but it's been working for me and I do recommend it, not as a replacement medication. I should also point out that this is a natural stain. It's something that's been used for a long time to dye clothing and stuff. It will dye your countertop. I have done that. It will also dye stainless steel for a while. I've had yellow patches from when I've made turmeric milk and poured it in the sink or like washed out my pot or whatever. It will eventually come off of metal. Don't know about anything else. So maybe just don't leave it randomly on the counter. Clean it up. Yeah, immediately. Sounds good. But I'm going to give you a fancier version of that to try at home. You're going to get 2 cups of any kind of non-dairy milk. You're going to use 1 tablespoon of turmeric, 3 cloves, 3 black cardamom pods, 1 canela, which is a cinnamon stick, the cheap kind, because you don't want to waste a real, like, real fancy cinnamon stick on this, unless you want to. It's totally up to you. And then you're going to use some agave or honey to taste. You're going to heat them all up together in a pot on the stove, or even maybe in the microwave, I don't know if that'll work. And you're gonna simmer them down for about 10 minutes just to make sure that you're getting all the aromatics out of the turmeric, but also out of the cloves and the cardamom and the cinnamon. After that, pour it in a glass, drink it warm, have a cozy night. We just had a snow day, so you know, turmeric milk was amazing. And I hope you enjoy.